Most library search tools are designed to support scholarly communication and research. I know that scholars research hyper-focus aspects of an issue, meaning their analysis is more specific than food security and more like how urban gardeners feel about growing food and how gardening can be leveraged to improve community food security. Because research is so specialized, I'll need to do more than enter terms into this database to find scholarly sources that align with my purpose, writing a college-level research paper that demonstrates that I've examined the causes of food disparities and evaluates the effectiveness of community-based programs addressing this issue, and my audience, an academic sociologist, my instructor, who will want to see evidence that I'm developing an understanding of sociological theories, approaches, and research methodologies. To do this, I'll want to refine my search results using filters. First, I'll enter my search terms, in this case, community gardens and food access. These terms give me close to 5,000 results, and although my search terms are highlighted all over the page, each source is using my terms in different ways. First, I'm going to use the source type filter to refine my results to only show articles from scholarly journals, because I'm required to use scholarly sources for this paper. Next, I'll check out the subject filter. I know I'm already using a search tool specific to sociology resources, so it'll be interesting to explore the other ways I can narrow the focus of my research within the broader field of sociology. When I click on More, a new window pops up with a list of subtopics found associated with the sources in my search results. Here I can specify that I only want to see sources about community gardens and food access that also relate to these focus areas. For now, I'll select food supply because I want to know more about how people access food. The subject filter allows me to see a more focused collection of sources and develop some awareness for the aspects of this issue that sociologists might think about. Applying this filter brings my results list down to under 100 titles, which will make it much easier for me to spot and choose sources that reflect the same parts of the scholarly conversation I'm trying to join. This article, Edible Backyards, a Qualitative Study of Household Food Growing and Its Contributions to Food Security, looks promising. I like this because it addresses both food security and gardening as a food source. It seems like a solid choice, but I'm going to check the article details before I commit to reading a full 16-page article. I'll go to the article abstract or summary first. This will explain the subject matter, scope, methodology, and conclusions of the study. Next, I'll scan for details like the terms linked in the subject section. This list of main ideas confirms that this article is about gardening and the food supply. It also gives me a new detail. The article deals with urban areas. Further down, I see common citation details like the authors, the publication date. I also see that this article was published in a journal titled Agriculture and Human Values, which confirms that this article addresses the human aspects of food production and access. I also see that the study was conducted in Canada, which could matter. I'm supposed to be studying an issue in the United States. I don't know enough about the relationship between gardening and local food supplies or U.S. food systems to know if this article will be applicable to my research. To be safe, I'm going to save this article by emailing myself the details so I can search for it later, or by downloading it. I'll keep searching until I'm more comfortable with the sociological conversation about food access and gardens. I'll need to go back to these search results and look for other perspectives on the issue. To do this, I might have to try different search terms or experiment with other filters and even other databases. And that's okay, because it's a natural part of the research process.